Withdrawal is a painful process that happens after someone stops taking a mind-altering substance. But why exactly is it so miserable? Hey guys, Julia here for D News. Withdrawal of any kind of substance can be harrowing and exhausting. Some of the most dramatic symptoms include nausea, sweating, shaking, and even hallucination. So what's going on? Why does withdrawal wreak such havoc on the body? First, let's talk drug addiction in general. There's lots of different substances you can become addicted to. While opioids are the most well-known addictive substances, alcohol and caffeine addictions are common too. You can get hooked on these substances because they alter the release of neurotransmitters and change the way the brain works, sometimes with pleasing results. But after long-term exposure to a drug, the brain tries to restore normal functioning through adaptations. This is what building up drug tolerance is. If this goes on for a long time, the user becomes dependent, needing the drug to maintain just normal functioning and avoid withdrawal symptoms. When that user goes off of the drug, the brain's compensation is still in place, leading the brain to be more active in certain areas. This leads to what's called withdrawal syndrome. Withdrawal symptoms can develop in 24 hours and last anywhere from a week to months on end. There's lots of different mechanisms that create dependency and withdrawal. One example is how opioids affect a brain chemical called noradrenaline. Opioids are known to cause drowsiness, slowed respiration, and low blood pressure. This is because opioids suppress the neurons that produce noradrenaline. Over time, with opioid dependence, the body counteracts the suppression by releasing more of the chemical to support these functions at normal level. But even if the user stops taking the drug, the body still releases an elevated level of noradrenaline, which produces withdrawal symptoms like jitters, anxiety, muscle cramps, and diarrhea. Similarly to how opioids affect noradrenaline, alcohol affects production of another brain chemical called GABA, which governs neuron activity. Too little GABA and neurons fire rapidly. You feel excited, hyper, thoughts are flying around a mile a minute. Too much GABA and neurons subside a bit. You feel calmer, more relaxed, sometimes too much, like stumbling around, slurring your words, kind of sedated. So you can guess which alcohol does. Yeah, it increases GABA. Chronic alcohol use impairs the ability of GABA to calm the brain down. So more GABA and thus more alcohol is needed to get the same relaxing effect. And once alcohol intake stops, GABA levels drop dramatically, which makes the brain overreact. And that can lead to things like teeth chattering, uncontrolled shaking, jumpiness, and even seizures. That last one can even be deadly. While you might think withdrawal doesn't apply to you, put that coffee down. I know most of you probably drink it. According to New Scientist, it's the world's most popular drug. But go without it for a day and you might experience a headache, tiredness, feeling low, foggy, less sociable, and even feeling like you've got the flu. Caffeine works on the receptors for the neurotransmitter adenosine. Adenosine facilitates sleep by calming the brain down. Caffeine sneaks in there and binds to adenosine receptors, so it blocks adenosine from doing its job. That's why you perk up with a morning cup of joe. Drinking caffeine regularly can also increase the number of adenosine receptors in the brain, so you need more caffeine to get the same effect, or in other words, you build up a tolerance. But caffeine also causes your brain to release dopamine, so you tend to feel good after your morning coffee. Then once you stop drinking coffee, you crash, because suddenly your body is without the feel-good boost and anti-sleepiness of the caffeine. Thankfully, withdrawal from caffeine only lasts a few days. One drug that's incredibly addictive and deadly is heroin, yet its use in the US is on the rise. What makes heroin so deadly? Find out more in this episode right here. The World Health Organization says heroin users face a 20 to 30 times higher risk of death than non-drug users. So how is the drug so powerful? Well, like most opioids, it works on certain receptors in the brain. All right, guys, do you have any other questions about science? Let us know down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to D News. We've got new episodes every day of the week.